Okay, very good day to all of you. Today, me and my friends are gonna give a basic show on how to use Photoshop in your daily life functions. Okay, so what we're trying to show you here is when you open the Photoshop first, there will be a menu bar to choose from. And already on the display, on the right side will be colors, layers, channels, some basic stuff for you to. Okay, so when you want to create a Photoshop file, you need to press new, insert your own name, and just click OK. The settings are up to you. You can change the resolution of the setting according to what you like. Okay, so right now what we are trying to show is just the basic functions of the buttons that needs to be used so that you have a easier understanding of this. Okay, so as you can see, we have crop tools here. Crop tools is very widely used in Photoshop. Cropping is for setting your own distinct size for your particular image. So if you want to crop out a small picture or a small picture from your bigger one, you have to use the crop tool. Okay, so after setting to what you like, you can see the other functions. And as you can see here, we have the gradient tool. And of course, you would like to pick your own color. Okay. So picking colors is very varied. You can make your own colors to be contrasting and all that. It's up to you. So after you pick color, you can use the magic wand tool. And from what you can see here, we can rotate the image according to where you want to put it. Photoshop is very flexible, so if you're trying to create any sort of background image, you can do it. It's very flexible. You can put anything anywhere. There are many tools for you to learn. So to write your own text into the PowerPoint, you have to use the horizontal tool or vertical, doesn't matter. If you want your words to be displayed vertically, you have to use the vertical type tool. And then you set your own size, your own font, according to what you like, style, any style you want, even color. Even the text can be rotated. But remember, when you start a new text, it's not as simple as that. When you start a new text, you have to... It gets a bit complicated. Okay. So for you to see the text on top of your color, you have to set it according to the layers. It means the text have to be above of the background layer for it to be seen. If the text is below, then the text cannot be seen. That is one tricky thing that you should understand. After that, you should go to styles and just choose whatever style that you think is necessary for you. You can put glows, you can put shadows, any kinds of styles. And of course, I mean, this is just a basic introduction, so you can do whatever you want to do. That's all pretty much for all the basic functions in Photoshop. And of course, the basic thing that you should know is how to save it. You can save it in many types of format. The most commonly used format is PNG, because you want to see the image properly. If you're not finished with your project, then you should just save it under the default software. But if you're done, then you can save it to a image file. In this case, it's a PNG. Open it with any software that opens your photo, and you can see it displayed. That's all for now.